All right, Jen St. Denis from Business of Vancouver is back with us. Good morning, Jen.
Hello.
Well, we're talking Black Friday, and of course, we want to see how many people are going to stay on this side of the border during that day.
Yeah, that's right. Black Friday, really an American tradition of shopping madness, but it's been migrating north of the border. And Canadian retailers, yeah, like you say, are really trying to get the word out this year that Canadian shoppers can stay up here. And they're actually expecting it to be the biggest Black Friday they've ever seen. And that part of that is really due to the low Canadian dollar, keeping Canadian shoppers here and not running south of the border to get that really great deal. Now, this year, there's a bit of an interesting twist, though. In BC especially, we're seeing a couple of the retailers, London Drugs and Best Buy, kind of in this competition to see who can offer the best deal on electronics. And that's because of Best Buy's decision to close the Future Shop brand and to close some of those stores. So Future Shop in the past really had the corner on the both the Black Friday deals and the Boxing Day sales for electronics. So we're going to see London Drugs and Best Buy kind of try to take that crown, as it were.
Well, I would also imagine that the Canadian dollar price has a lot to do with what's going to happen. That it's not getting as good a deal if you do go down to the States.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, the whole effort of going down to the States and braving those, I would say, you know, crazier crowds that happen with the American Black Friday sales, our Canadian consumers just going to say, well, I'll see what's available up here. I'm sure that Canadian retailers are hoping that's the case.
All right. Well, the good news is that CIBC is now forecasting some good economic news for us in 2016.
Yeah, they're forecasting that in 2016, BC is going to lead the Canadian economy in terms of economic growth. So they're forecasting that BC is going to see 2.8% growth in 2016 compared to the Canadian average of 1.9%. And so the second biggest province would be Ontario at 2.4%. Hmm. So some of the factors behind that, they say, are overseas investment in BC, also that our proximity to the U.S. economy, and the U.S. economy is doing well, is going to be good for this province. There are certain sectors like tourism that are especially benefiting from the low Canadian dollar as well. Now, of course, this is in contrast to what's happening in provinces like Alberta and Saskatchewan. Now, those provinces in years past were the leaders in economic growth. That's no longer the case because of the oil and gas price slide that we're seeing.
All right. Good stuff. Okay, Jen, thank you very much.
Thanks.
If you want more details from Jen, you can go to BIV.com.